Good afternoon, Corden Sroka, recording from Allendale's trading floor here, bringing you your afternoon wrap-up on this Thursday, November 17th, 2011. A very exciting trading day today in the grains. Corn finishing down 28 and a quarter at 614 and a half. We had beans down 19 and a half at 1168 and a quarter. And we had wheat down 24 and a quarter at 592 and a half. Reasons behind a lot of the move today. Got a lot of guys were calling two reasons here. One, poor export sales in the corn today. Exports coming in at about 209,000 tons with expectations looking for 250 to 600,000 tons. The other factor in here has been macro liquidation. We've seen it in gold, silver, crude, as well as the stock market today. Really not too much of a reason out there other than European fears starting to flare up again here in the market. Selling accelerated in the corn once we took out some key technical areas, 630 and a quarter and then 622 as some of our past lows, with the low today being all the way down at 610 and a quarter. The European fear, what guys are talking about now is Spain, France, and Italy's borrowing costs are continuing to move higher little by little. So that's what's affecting the markets, at least the macros today. The other talk for corn here is that feed wheat is much cheaper than corn. In some places, a dollar a bushel less to feed wheat than it would be corn. Therefore, we're going to need to do something to get a little demand started back up here again. Beans export sales today came in at about 751,000 tons with expectations of about 450 to 700,000 tons. So we did have good bean export sales today, as well as a good purchase this morning announced of about 420,000 tons of beans sold to China. So we did still see beans down 19 and a half, which really leads to the fact that we're seeing just macro liquidation by the big money running out of these markets today. We did hold the lows again today, even though we are in a weak technical formation. Holding those lows today does look good. So the lows that we put in were 1162. Some of the past lows we had seen down around here have been that 1163 area as well. So 1160, if we take that out, we could find ourselves with a little bit more pressure. There was also some talk on the floor today that MF Global could have been liquidating a few positions, which could have also caused some of this overall commodity liquidation idea or mentality that the trade had today. Wheat export sales today came in about 335,000 tons. Expectations looking for 300 to 500,000 tons. They just continued to follow corn lower as global stocks of wheat are ample and at I believe, 10-year highs. Black Sea wheat, Australian wheat, and South American wheat all cheaper on the world markets than what we're selling here in the States. So we're going to need to see some more pressure, like I'd said before, with the corn to get a little bit more demand starting up for the wheat. Cattle today. Feedlots asking for higher prices, but the packer is still cutting kill, so we're not likely to see much trade up at those higher levels. We've got a cattle on feed report tomorrow with the placements number being the key number to watch. The estimates are coming in at about 99 for placements, so a little bit below last month. Hogs today, very strong day today on the hogs, up $1.90. December contract, they're trading 87.50. Speculators are in here trying to pick a seasonal bottom in the cash market. That's what's helping the hogs bounce a little bit here today. And this week was probably one of the biggest weeks of the year for kill that we will see in the hogs. So we're going to see a lot of pork coming on the market here pretty quick, but a lot of guys are starting to look, you know, what's after that point. And that's why we're trying to toy with finding some support here. A lot of guys just dabbling in the waters a little bit. Outside markets today, as I had said, we're seeing a lot of pressure on gold and silver. Gold down $55 an ounce at $17.19. Silver down $2.21 an ounce. In corn terms, that's equivalent to about a $2 move in the corn. So a big move there today in the silver market. Crude oil down about $3.45 a barrel at $99.17, so back below that psychological $100 a barrel figure. And it all just comes back to, as I'd said before, European fears. Spain, Italy, and now France. France is not dealing with a debt crisis, but the fact that they're trying to hold up the good portion of the Eurozone is it's costing them a little bit more to try and do so. I just want to remind you guys as well about our conference coming up here. We've got that in late January, the 20th and 21st. If you want to see a lot more of the good market information we're providing over here at Allendale, come out. It's going to be a good time. We're going to have a lot of good speakers this year talking about a lot of very broad amount of topics. So give us a call into your broker here at Allendale. See what we have going on there. Also, check out our website. We have information on the conference on our website. It is allendale-inc.com. Or give us a call at 800-262-7538. If you guys have any questions about what we're seeing here in the trade today or why we're moving how we are, give us a call. We'll help you guys understand that. And we'll start looking towards a price in a little bit of 2012. So take care. Have yourselves a good rest of the week and a good weekend. And we'll talk to you next week. Thanks.